Hi, I'm Joe Beavan. We're having a wee break from all the boring office subjects. I'm going to talk about one of my main hobbies, which is, as you see, the Eurovision Song Contest. One of my friends, classmates, is a Eurovision enthusiast. I've been watching it since 1981, so it's 32, 33 years now. So I'm just going to look at some facts about the Eurovision. Jim around with us. Why do I like it myself? Some of the famous artists that have competed in it. My main interest of it is the lack of live music during the shows. And also the campaign that I'm part of to bring the orchestra back to Eurovision. And what is the way forward? So, 1956. Gentlemen there, Marcel Bessin, you have to apologise for the pronunciation. Marcel Bessinton, who was the Director General of the EBU at the time, created the Eurovision Song Contest as a method of exchanging techniques about cameras and productions across the world. It wasn't necessarily used as a contest for song, but that's the main part of it. That's the first one of 1956, Lusacia. Right, who this year attempted to take part in this year's Eurovision Song Contest at the age of 89. She joined a rapping group called New Jack, and it did do rather well in the Swiss national final. Ireland, the country that's won the most Eurovision titles. So in 1970 we had Dana, who was an MEP for a while. Mr. Eurovision, Johnny Logan. Linda Martin. Eve Kavanagh. Paul Harrington, Charlie McGethin. Then Eva Quinn, who was the last winner in 1996. Now, this is a Eurovision legend. He got this tape in 1980 when he retired. Noel Callaghan, who conducted the Eurovision Orchestra each year from 1966 up until his retirement from the music scene in 1998. Also known as well for composing music for U2, which is one of his hidden talents and no one ever knew about until he passed away. And a bit of the funny aspects, none of you might remember except one person in the room. ABBA, when they took part in the Eurovision 1974, the song Waterloo relating to Napoleon. Their conductor Sven Olof Waldorf dressed up as Napoleon when he walked onto the podium. That's one of the most funniest parts of Eurovision. 1989, going to Temel Selçuk from Turkey, designed a new way of method of conducting for the orchestra. Basically all he did was for 3 minutes of the entry was jump about that podium non-stop. And at the end, all you just saw him was brushing his eyebrows in the end. 1989 also then what I'd call a game of passing the baton to one conductor to another. The Danish entry, Henrik Rosgaard, he actually left the podium to start singing with the rest of the band and passed it on to the chief conductor, Ben Ulf Kaufman, at the time. Now, why do I like it? Over the years, there have been so many daft titles of music. That title won in 1968. Had 178 La La La's in it. And who did it beat? Cliff Richards, congratulations. By at 1 point. 1967, song called Boom Bada Boom. That was continuously through it, that was from Monaco. 1975 for the Netherlands, Ding a Ding Dong, which also won. That's another stupid one I found for Luxembourg, Pom Pom. Now look at some famous artists. If you can remember the film Grease, Olivia Newton-John, it's about 4 years before it. She sang for the UK, singing Long Live Love. 1988, a singer that went on to sing the Titanic theme, My Heart Will Go On, Celine Dion. He won it for Switzerland at the age of 17. And last, not least, an actress in EastEnders at the moment, Samantha Womack, who 22 years ago was known as Samantha Janis, sang Message to Your Heart for the UK and came 10th. Now, no orchestra. 1956 to 1958 there was an orchestra used. It more likely was a symphony orchestra of that country. 1999, first time ever, they got rid of the orchestra, citing the lack of space, which is a load of rubbish, because the first time they used no orchestra, it was the same venue as they used years before. So they used recorded music, i.e. tapes. Now the part that I'm involved in is we've been trying to get the EBU, the European Broadcasting Union, to bring back full orchestral music. We keep getting told no, no chance, because it's the cost of hiring an orchestra. I've even got that answer back from the scrutineers, people that need out the votes and that. Dutch Orchestra, the Metropole Orchestra in the Netherlands, they offer to play free of charge every year. Now, I've seen about playback, tape music. Some MGs also use orchestral music with playback. 1990, conductor Eduardo Leiva stood there for about two, three minutes, just with his hands raised for the orchestra to count them in. Nothing happened. Later on, when my pal interviewed him, he admitted that the technicians of the in Zagreb Television had actually forgotten to press play on the backing tapes, and when they eventually did, the song started halfway through the music, resulting in the actual performers walking off the stage, causing a bit of a problem, and having to restart it. Obviously, the second time they restarted, got it bang on. So, now I come to the end of my presentation. So, what's the way forward? Obviously, bring back the orchestra. That's an absolute must. Get rid of backing music. I hate backing music, full stop. And quite a few links available for fans of Eurovision. The main one, Eurovision.tv, is a primary source where the information's got videos, clips of music, how to get tickets for the contest, how to apply for accreditation. The website that I help out with sometimes, dealing with all the history of the conductors, my sort of job in it is to find them by using the internet and tracking them down, because most of them are in their 70s, 80s now, and so far I've found quite a few of them from my pals to interview. ESE Today, just basically a news site, up to the minute news about Eurovision, people have put out new records and so forth. So we come to the final part, for the end. So, most people think my subject is absolutely rubbish, absolutely boring. So it's the end now, so if you have any questions, provided you're not asleep already, I'll gladly answer them.
What attracted you to Eurovision, like when the first time you watched?
Music. Purely the music.
Do you have am I right in thinking you've got a personal interest in orchestra?
Yeah.
Do you
play? I used to play in the Glasgow Schools Concert Band, Glasgow Schools Brass Band, played in my secondary school orchestra with the tuba, euphonium.
Which instrument?
Tuba, mm-hmm. Euphonium, which is the sort of baby tuba.
Are you still playing?
No. I can think about the keyboards a wee bit.
So, am I right from this, your argument was that you are wanting away the backing music, the synthesizers and so forth,
yeah.
And you want live orchestra music?
Live orchestra
to
music.
To back up the singers?
Yeah.
Ah, great, that's a good point. Very good.
Should work.
Any other questions, folks? Well done, Joe, that was excellent.